Jesus, who is called the Christ, and I just want to say I'm glad to be here tonight. To our honored and esteemed Pastor-elect Brent Brown. Help me to thank God for it. Chapter 9 of the Gospel according to St. John. Chapter 9 of the Gospel according to St. John. Verse 1. Now tonight I'm going to read from the New International Version of Scripture. If you found that place in your Bibles, would you say amen?
Amen.
This is the word of the Lord. As he went along, he saw a man blind from birth. His disciples asked him, "Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" "Neither this man nor his parents sinned," Jesus said, "but this happened so that the works of God might be made manifest in him." As long as it is day, we must do the works of him who sent me. Night is coming when no man can work. While I am in the world, I am the light of the world. After saying this, he spit on the ground, made some mud with the saliva, put it on the man's eyes. "Go," he told him, "wash in the pool of Siloam." This word means sent. So the man went and washed and came home seeing. This is the word of the Lord. You may be seated. I want to put a tag on this text tonight, and for the moments that are ours to share with you from the word of the Lord, I want to talk about a model of ministry. A model of ministry. He and she that have ears to hear, let them hear what the Spirit says unto the church. A model
for you, and you know it was nobody but the Lord. If that's you, come on, just hunch your neighbor and say, "Neighbor, ain't got time to tell you my whole story. Just know this: God has blessed me." Done some things for me that I know I could not have done for myself. The Bible says that Jesus comes upon this blind man, and he's going to teach these fellas a lesson in ministry. How do you deal with pitiful people? Because after all, Great Harvest and Shiloh and every other church that is represented here, if you are a Christian, your assignment is to deal with pitiful people. So the question is, how do you deal with pitiful people? Well, the Bible says Jesus, after correcting the fellas and reminding them of who he was, and it is a reminder, because you know, in one chapter earlier, that is chapter 8, Jesus says, "I am the light of the world." And then in chapter 9, he has to repeat it again. Isn't that amazing? Only one chapter, and Jesus has to repeat the same statement. Oh, did y'all get it? No, you ain't get it. Maybe that's the reason why sometimes God has to send the same word, just to remind you of what he said is true. I am the light of the world. Now I'm getting ready to prove it, because this man is living in darkness, and I'm the only one who can give him light. Lord have mercy. you got to get down and dirty. But then Jesus teaches, secondly, you got to touch and talk. Touch people and talk to them. Touch. Lord have mercy. We live in an age, unfortunately, past we live, where there are so many untouchable Christians. Lord have mercy. We live in an age where folk don't want to touch one another. And in fact, sometimes even in church, when you ask somebody, just touch your neighbor, they're going to sit there and they ain't touching nobody. Let me see how you roll. Don't just touch somebody. Just touch. Because there's power in a touch. Sometimes that's all you gotta do. Like that woman with the issue of blood who said, I ain't even gotta look in his eyes. Jesus teaches the word can get you out. In John, the 5th chapter, Jesus teaches the word can get you up. And in John, the 6th chapter, Jesus teaches the word will get you through.
Sure.